Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States until our country's representatives can figure out what the hell is going on.
This sweltering summit of the Negro's legitimate discontent will not pass until that is an invigorating autumn of freedom and equality. 1963 is not an end, but a beginning.
Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. All things are now forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixie.
Those who hope that the Negro needed to blow off steam and will now be content will have a rude awakening if the nation returns to business as usual. There will be neither rest nor tranquility in America until the Negro is granted his citizenship right.
For Dixieland. I was born early low on frosty morn. Look away, look away.
Look we cannot away. Be satisfied as long as a Negro in Mississippi cannot vote, and a Negro in New York believes he has nothing for which to
glory,
vote.
Glory, glory.
I have a dream.
Hallelujah. Yeah, glory, glory, hallelujah.
Now is the time.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. It's true.
Can never be satisfied as long as the Negro is the fifth victim of the unspeakable horrors of the
brutality.
We can never be satisfied.
You know,
as long as our body is heavy with the fatigue of travel, cannot gain lodging in the motels and the highways and the hotels of the city.
But oh.
Be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. Now is the time to make real the promises of democracy. We must not allow our creative protests to degenerate into physical violence. Again and again, we must rise to the majestic heights of meeting physical force with soul force. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
No, I'm not a racist.